An Ohio couple faces felony charges after their malnourished son escaped from their home. The teen was found weighing 65 pounds and had to be hospitalized. The child was on a very strict vegan diet, mostly consisting of almonds, bananas, and grapes. He was kept under strict surveillance to keep him from eating anything else. The parents were charged with one count of kidnapping, one count of assault, and two counts of child endangerment. They are facing up to 22 years in prison, but as we've seen in the past, these vegans tend to get off with nothing or some community service. The boy's biological father was reported to have committed assault on the child when he wouldn't eat the way they told him to, apparently at the wish of the mother, who said she consulted with an out-of-state doctor through the internet, putting the boy on a strict diet they called Naturalist, allegedly to keep him healthy after he survived cancer as a newborn. They said it was tough to tell if the poor person was a boy or girl. He was so emaciated when he was in the hospital, his arms only 2 to 3 inches around. This child was forced on this diet for the past 3 years, being tortured by these vegan lunatics. A lot of vegans try to dismiss these stories, but this is the truth of what's behind every vegan's head. They would do this to any human being if it meant not consuming animal foods. We aren't hearing about normal parents starving their children, mainly because once you remove animal foods from a human diet, health declines incredibly rapidly. Just this year, we have had so many stories of this occurring. Back in February, vegan parents starved their baby because the formula they were feeding him wasn't vegan. The baby was only 8 pounds at 5 months old, half of a normal weight. In May, there was a Swedish couple whose baby girl's condition was worse than anything they had seen in the hospital before. Being just hours from dying, this baby was on a diet of breast milk, brown rice, and potatoes. Breast milk is supposed to be adequate to nurse a child on its own for several years, but when the mother is following a vegan diet, her breast milk will not contain the nutrients needed for survival, let alone optimal growth. Also in May, there was an Australian couple who starved their child on the vegan diet they followed themselves, consisting mostly of tofu, rice, and potatoes, claiming that the child was a fussy eater. Interesting how a baby's natural instinct is telling them not to consume these plant foods that are devoid of nutrition. This is just the tip of the iceberg. There are dozens and dozens of these stories that have occurred in just the past few years that you can dig up. And some of these children weren't so fortunate. There have been many deaths from malnourished vegan babies as well as children. The position of the American Dietetic Association is that appropriately planned vegan diets are adequate for all stages of life. Unfortunately, the author of that study, Craig W.J., is a Seventh-day Adventist. The Seventh-day Adventist Church is a very large religious group that believes strongly in vegetarian and vegan diets. They are behind a lot of the anti-animal food propaganda we see in the media, and I will link a video at the end here about eggs where I explain the origins of this church further. It's scary how deep the roots of the Seventh-day Adventist Church go, but what is even scarier is the state of our health now. People are already sick, dying, unhappy, living on a standard American diet in their own little worlds. To deprive yourself of nutrition further by going vegan is a step in the wrong direction. There is a subjective genetic tolerance that needs to be addressed. Some people go vegan and get so sick after 2 months that they need to start eating meat again. Others last several years before falling apart. And of course, you have those people who were suffering the whole 2 to 3 years and were insisting that it wasn't the lack of animal foods in their diet. Some babies die of cancer at 3 months old. Some people go on to be the greatest athletes in the world. And it's not genetics, it's environment. Genetics are directly determined by environment. When you put a baby or a child on a vegan diet, the true negative health benefits are apparent. During these developmental stages of life, nutrition from animal foods is critical. Whether it's needing glasses and braces, being the shortest kid in the class, or having acne, those are nothing compared to a parent losing their child without understanding the true cause. Veganism is an extreme example of what is going on in a larger scale. Vegans are brainwashed that their diet is healthy, just like we are brainwashed that all of the bad things we do in our day-to-day life are okay. Vegans think they are benefiting the environment, and most people are convinced that meat causes global warming, and vegans believe they are morally and ethically superior to other people. But reality is, both vegans and the standard mainstream cultural ideas are incorrect. But vegans are destroying people's health by spreading their message. A vegan diet is not healthy. True health comes from a high fat-soluble vitamin intake, specifically from animal foods. Of course, the mainstream is likely never going to understand this, and convincing people after they've been told meat will kill them for 50 years is an impossible task. Conventional agriculture, regardless of whether you are growing corn and soy or raising animals in feedlots, is damaging the environment. Whether you buy broccoli or grain-fed steak, you are supporting the type of farming that is detrimental to our environment and the people that are trying to control the food supply or are controlling the food supply incredibly well. We are destroying the soil with commercial farming methods, whereas natural agriculture actually regenerates the environment. You don't hear vegans complaining about bison farting as they are roaming the plains. This ties into the moral and ethical aspect. Grinding up rabbits and fawns in a harvester isn't any better than slicing a cow's throat. Spraying herbicides and pesticides to kill trillions of insects falls in line with the amount of insects vegans consume in their bug butters and mugs of ants in the morning. Vegans simply have a disregard for human life because they love cute, cuddly animals. You would be hard-pressed to find a vegan that doesn't own a cat or a dog, and most of them frequent like farms that are kind of like petting zoos, and they can interact with piglets, baby goats, anything with big eyes that makes cute noises. Unfortunate that people can, you know, fall so in love with the appearance of something that makes them warm and fuzzy inside, and because of that, they will literally kill their children. Gets really crazy once you put it into context of what's actually happening. The level of brainwashing is unfortunate. Hopefully this message can spread and I can continue to improve the health of as many people as I can. So thank you guys for joining me. If you could please like the video, subscribe, hit that bell icon, and share the video if you can. If you guys would like to support me further, definitely check out Frankie's Free Range Meats, high quality, nutrient dense, naturally raised animal foods at an affordable price. Go to frankiesfreerangemeat.com. We just came out with an organ grind with ground beef that has about 10%, some liver, kidney, and heart. Wagyu beef is going to be out soon, guys, by the weekend. You can also check out Frankie's Naturals, minimal ingredients, minimally processed hygiene and cosmetic products if you want to look like a Roman statue. So thanks again for joining me, guys, and enjoy the rest of your day.